hope I'm not being presumptuous, but I'd like to ask you a favor. Would you mind donating some medical samples, even just a blood sample?
I might, for some caps.
You want to dicker about money? People's lives are at stake here. Either do it because it's the right thing to do, or I'll wait for the next Commonwealth visitor. Just have a seat, and I'll draw some blood. Sit there. This'll only take a sec. There. Hardly hurt a bit, eh? Thank you. This will be a great help. Now, I need to get these prepared immediately. If you get sick or injured, go to Rachel first. She'll call me if it's worth my effort.
Rusty really takes it out of you.
You've no idea, Mr.
Hey, can you both just get lost? You're killing my buzz here.
With pleasure, sir.
Fine, get caught. Then you won't have the choice to leave because the Overseer will make it for you. Hey, Outsider, do me a favor. If my good-for-nothing brother asks you for Jet, tell him to buzz off.
Who's your brother?
His name's Bobby, and he's my poor excuse for a twin, so you can get a good idea of what he looks like. Look, he's a junkie, but he's getting careless. If he gets caught, we're both in trouble. And as much as I'd like to leave this canned paradise, that's not how I want to go.
If he's addicted, you should try to help him get clean.
I don't think I haven't tried. I locked him in his room for a week. It wasn't 2 days before he was using again. Now I admit, I've got my own share of the blame here. Bobby gets his chems from me, and I keep him on a short leash. But not anymore. I'm cutting off his useless ass.
Good. That's the first step to helping your brother.
Should have done it a long time ago. But things ain't easy around here.
Hey, the Outsider. You lost? No trading going on down here.
Just taking a look around.
Well, only the old generators to see down here. Oh, and hey, if you got any Jet on you, I may be willing to take it off your hands. Say, 75 caps?
help you there.
Damn. Well, if you change your mind or start feeling charitable, look me up. Just don't let Tina know. She'd be all over my ass.
Direct any maintenance requests to Mr. DeLuca.
That wanderer from the Commonwealth. I'm Rachel. I assist Dr. Forsyth with his medical duties. Are you sick or injured?
Patch me up, Doc.
Now, go over your symptoms for me, one at a time.
Too much radiation. I feel sick.
All right. Let's flush your system. That's that. Anything else bothering you?
No, we're done.
Take better care of yourself in the future, okay?
Looking for medical treatment? Talk to Rachel. She'd be happy to help you with anything you need.
Dr. Forsyth.
I've heard some doctors out there specialize in facial reconstruction. I can't imagine attempting surgery in those conditions.
Doing quite well.
Pardon me, Dr. Penske.
Very little discoloration. Strong cellular plant structure. Gonna need more fertilizer soon. I'll have to see how it holds up to exposure. Ah, you'll do perfectly. I'm in need of a willing test subject to try this new strain of fruit I've created.
Sure. I like fruit.
Excellent. Just tell me how it tastes and how it makes you feel. Now, where did I put that Geiger counter?
Dr. Penske.
I can't seem to get the potatoes right. Did you try the fruit? Tell me, how was it?
Adverse effects.
I knew it. This is good progress. I'll have to start a new batch right away. Since you've been so helpful, maybe you can help out in another capacity. You see, I need these plants to conduct my studies, and they take some special nourishment, especially the carrots. If you could keep an eye out for fertilizer while you're out in the Commonwealth, I'll be more than happy to compensate you for your efforts.
Sure, I can do that.
Really? Great. I was dreading having to put in another request to the Overseer. Just bring by whatever you can find whenever you have the time.
Excuse me, Dr. Penske.
Oh dear, I seem to have misplaced one of my instruments. Where could it be?
Dr. Penske runs a hydroponics lab here. She may have some work for you if you're interested.
Don't want any trouble.
Most people are good at breaking things. I enjoy putting them back together.
One day, Sanctuary will be a vibrant community. I've seen it.
Okay, out with it.
Ready to head back out?
Ready.
Good. Then let's get moving.
Seems I'm gonna be missing out on all the fun.
You have no idea, Hancock. No idea.
Rather be off murdering a pint.
This'll do.
right, we stand to make a whole lot of money. Just a grind. Hell, I have a ton of them.
You're gonna drag that junk around.
Thank you.
speaking. I'm listening.
I need to assign someone to this. I need to assign someone to this. I need to assign someone to this.
Leave me alone. I've got work to do.
If you want a good meal, see Maria at the cafeteria. She'll hook you up. You're whipping up a new batch of pies today? I heard Alexis promised one to Erin, and I know how you hate to disappoint the little ones.
Marcus William Somerset. Oh, don't you go on thinking you're so clever. Those pies are going to be for Calvin and his crew. Lord knows they could use a treat right now.
Hey, you try telling that to Erin and breaking the little girl. My wife was so cold-blooded.
40 years of marriage. Count your blessings, you're still alive. If you want a good meal, stop by the Sunshine Diner come morning.
Excuse me, Maria.
Glad the day's over with. These old bones need a good rest.
Commonwealth hasn't gotten you yet. Yeah?
I heard one of the kids got bit by some sort of mutant rat. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah?
Hard to keep my mind on business with that little boy sick. If you need anything, just let me know.
run this place by yourself?
Heavens no, I'd be a wreck. My husband, Mark, he helps me. Though mostly with the tasting.
Is it hard work, feeding everyone here?
It used to be easier. Back when I was young, we had more supplies than we could count. Why, my mother taught me some recipes that had ingredients that... Well, I doubt you could find them anywhere anymore. Since we started trading, we manage well enough, but the variety, let's just say it's more than a bit lacking.
Have you ever thought about leaving the vault?
Never. Can you imagine? Born and raised right here in Vault 81. It was easier back then, you know. Supplies were high, and the dangers outside were both severe and unknown. Poor Gwen didn't know what she was getting into when she accepted the role of Overseer.
How is Gwen doing as the Overseer?
It weighs on her, I can tell. We need help from the Commonwealth, but a few people, they don't care for it. Not to mention the state of the vault. Upkeep's got people working round the clock these days. Even me. If people are going to be up all night working, they'll need a good meal to keep them going.
Not today.
Suit yourself. But if you're hungry later, you can't say I didn't try.
You're a good boy, Frank.
We got a barber here if you need it.
You should stop by and see Horatio over here. Can't imagine you come across many barbers.
Looking pretty bad in there. I don't know about you, but I can't stand to see any of those youngins.
Stay out of trouble.
Until I know what he's infected with.
Dr. Forsythe.
Not now. And you, stranger, will have to wait your turn. We have an emergency here. Austin got bitten by a mole rat. Isn't that enough, Jacob? There can't be that many mole rat diseases or toxins.
Rachel is examining the mole rat. Hopefully she'll find something. But these aren't ordinary mole rats. Who knows what kind of diseases they are carrying? Because he's just a child, it's affecting him more severely.
Dr. Forsythe, please. I think I found something that might help Austin.
Bobby!
Hold on, Priscilla. What is it, Bobby?
Well, you know that door Austin found? He found it because of me. I keep my private things in there. He saw me get them.
You mean your chems?
Get to the point, Bobby. What did you find in that place?
It's like a whole extra vault in there, but half ruined and caved in. There was this terminal there. So I started poking around in it. There were some notes and stuff about using mole rats to grow viruses. But they also said that they used them to make vaccines and treatments.
A secret vault? Good Lord, I've never heard of such a thing.
Bobby, you're a genius. A junkie genius. There might be a cure for whatever Austin got from that mole rat somewhere in that place. You there, how would you like to do Vault 81 a favor and possibly save my boy's life?
I would be glad to help.
I was hoping I could count on you. Bobby here will show you where he keeps his secret stash. There is a chance that somewhere in there is a cure for Austin. If you find it, bring it to Dr. Forsythe. And for Austin's sake, please hurry.
Follow me.